In this illustration, we'll study about the maximum thermal power generated in a resistance. Here, in the figure shown, we are required to find the value of resistance R at which thermal power generated in it be the highest, and we are also required to find this maximum thermal power. Here, we know well by maximum power transfer theorem, we have already studied in concept videos that for maximum thermal power to be produced in R, the value of R should be equals to the internal resistance of the circuit, that is the Thevenin's resistance of the circuit across terminals A and B. Here, if we remove this R and find out the equivalent resistance across A and B for the remaining circuit, here you can see the value will be R1 and R2 in parallel. So, the internal resistance of circuit across terminals A and B, we can see it is R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. This implies for maximum power to be dissipated in this resistance, the value of R should be equals to R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. That will be the result of this problem, the resistance at which thermal power in it is maximum. If we wish to find out the maximum value of this power, first we'll calculate the Thevenin's EMF across terminals A and B, where we can consider if this R is removed, these two batteries of EMFs E1 and E2 will be taken in parallel. So here, Thevenin's EMF of circuit can be written as VAB, that is the potential difference across terminals A and B, and that can be given as this is E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So, if we simplify this value here, we can see this is E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by this is R1 plus R2. So, this is the equivalent EMF for these two batteries in parallel. So, in this situation, if the circuit is replaced by Thevenin's equivalent circuit, which we have studied, here we can write down this Thevenin, we can redraw this Thevenin equivalent circuit as, this is the battery, we can write as VAB, the Thevenin's EMF across A and B, and an internal resistance which can be written as R internal of AB. And then we connect across terminals A and B the resistance R which we have removed. And in this situation, the value of R should be equals to this internal resistance for maximum power to be produced. So here we can write down the value of maximum power, which is equals to VAB by the total resistance in the circuit is 2R, this whole square multiplied by R. So, we substitute the value, this is VAB whole square by 4R, that is the maximum thermal power produced in this resistance. On substituting the value of R, we can see the result we are getting is E1 R2 plus E2 R1 whole square divided by 4 times R1 R2 multiplied by R1 plus R2. That will be the final result of this problem.